Hi there, Slack developers. In this video, we're talking about modals, the App Home and the API methods that power them, views.publish and views.open. If you're already familiar with building Slack apps, share with us in the comments what your experience was when creating your first Slack app. But if you're just getting started, you're in the right place. You probably already know that your app can post messages in Slack, but what about when you want to gather information from someone or present information that goes beyond just a post? That's where the modals in the App Home come in. Let's start with modals. Modals are user-triggered pop-ups idea for requesting and collecting data from users or temporarily displaying dynamic and interactive information. Modals in Slack app are equivalent to alert boxes, pop-ups, or dialog boxes. They are a very powerful piece of app functionality because they capture and maintain the user's focus within Slack until the user performs any action. Each model has some standardized UI elements: a title, an X button to dismiss the model, a cancel button, and a modals view. Modals are composed using Blockit, the UI framework that powers advanced Slack applications. A modal can contain any type of block you want, from input fields, date pickers, to images. The method that accompanies a modal is views.open. As I mentioned before, a modal needs to be triggered by the user, so views.open requires a trigger ID. Trigger IDs are sending an action payload when the end user engages with your app via a button or a shortcut, and then receives a JSON payload with any completed form field back. In the case, the model contains a form. But models are not only used for capturing data from forms. You can use them to get feedback after a user interaction, display information, or anything you want to share with the user without leaving Slack. In order to allow interactivity, we need to activate it for our app from the Slack app management UI. Let's see how. From your app management dashboard, go to Interactivity and Shortcuts. Enable the Interactivity toggle if it's not already enabled. You will need to add a request URL. A request URL is where Slack is going to send the interaction payload to and notify your app about the interaction. In case you have socket mode enabled, Interactivity will be automatically enabled as well. If you want to know more about how to create and trigger modals, check out this video. Now that we know what makes modals special, let's see the App Home. The App Home is a space within your app in which developers can organize and display the most commonly used features or interactions of the app. For example, a list of today's appointments in the case of a calendar app. This space is specific to each user and generated at runtime. This means that every time the App Home space is opened, the developer has an opportunity to create a completely unique view just for that user at that moment. The Home tab is fully customizable. Usually, when you switch to an app via the Quick Switcher or the Conversation sidebar, you're presented with a conversation thread just like you would be with any human coworker. But apps have the ability to activate the App Home, and here's how to set that up. Check that your app has at least one permission to enable the Home tab. To check this, click on All Auth and Permissions in the sidebar. If your app doesn't already have a scope, then select one under the bot token scopes. Now let's go back to the sidebar and select the App Home tab. Scroll down to the Show Tabs block and enable the Home tab toggle if it's not already enabled. The Home tab is now enabled, but now you will need to install or reinstall your app. For that, go back to the sidebar and click on Install App. Now click on Allow to install or reinstall to workspace. Now your Home tab is successfully enabled.
Once again, our Blockit tool will help you prototype it and visualize it before you start writing any code. The App Home is composed using Blockit, similar to modals. With our Blockit Builder tool, you'll be able to prototype your App Home space and will even generate the necessary JSON that you can copy into your app's code.
If you're curious about all the things that you can do in your app home and how to build them, don't forget to check out this video. The method associated with the app home is views.publish. This method listens to the app home opened event to respond with the proper blocky.json payload. This is the event that detects new visitors on your home tab, and you can choose what to respond with to welcome the user, onboard them, share tips or updates, or prompt them for taking some actions such as finishing the configuration. Now that we know when to use modals and the app home, let's talk about views. Views are the visual areas that will contain the blocks that make up your interface. To define these views, apps create view objects. There are packages of information that describe layout, interactivity, and other useful metadata. Views objects are used within both web API methods, views.publish and views.open. So remember, you want to use the views.open method when you want to open a model, while you will use the views.publish method when you're working on your app home. I hope you find this video useful, especially if you're just getting started building Slack apps. If you do, let us know with a thumbs up. Also, write us on Twitter what other type of content would you like us to cover. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out any of our upcoming videos. See you in the next one.